friends, welcome to Sustainability with Maddie. I am Maddie, and today we are going to be talking about whether or not an environmental science degree is worth it. I want to talk about this because there currently seems to be a lot of frustration in the online environmental space about the job market for environmentalists and environmental scientists specifically. A lot of people are saying that they can't find a job and that when they do find a job, they get paid pennies. And the general response to that is that if you work hard enough, you'll be okay. But that doesn't tell the whole story, and it's a little more nuanced than that. I know when I was pursuing my environmental science degree, I had a ton of questions. So if you have any questions, please feel free to email me. I have my email in the description box below, and I will be happy to answer any questions you have. I know it is a very tough market out there, so let's explore whether or not an environmental science degree is actually worth it. I got my undergraduate degree in environmental science, so I'll speak on my opinion on whether or not it's worth it, but I'll also share the general consensus online and what the stats say about the actual job market. So let's start with the basics. What are environmental scientists? Well, they are, as the name implies, scientists that study the natural environment. Historically, there's been a lot of political influence on the field of environmental science. So the general field as a whole is considered to be, from Forbes, the intersection between social sciences and the natural sciences. Generally, students who major in environmental science along with their courses in the natural sciences will take other courses in environmental policy and environmental law and management. If you are considering pursuing an undergraduate degree in environmental science, or maybe you are already doing so, you might be asking, what does the curriculum actually involve? Well, first, it involves your core courses, generally on the natural sciences. You'll be taking courses in things like water quality, air quality, soil science, agricultural science, animal and plant sciences, and ecology. But as the definition from Forbes implies, you will also be taking courses in the social sciences like environmental policy or environmental law. As for my experience, for those who haven't seen my previous videos, I did go to the University of Maryland and majored in environmental science and policy. And within that, I concentrated in biodiversity and conservation biology. So you could imagine a lot of my courses revolved around biology and chemistry, as well as ecological systems and conservation strategies. That said, even though it was a more science-focused concentration, I did still take classes every single year in environmental policy and environmental law. Those were actually some of my favorite courses and helped inform what my actual job became after I graduated, which is more focused on the policy side of things. What is the industry currently looking like right now? Let's just run through some quick stats on the environmental science field as a whole to help you evaluate whether or not it's worth it. So, according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, the 2023 median pay for environmental scientists and specialists, because they do group them together, was $78,980 per year. The typical entry-level education was a bachelor's degree, that's what we're talking about today. And the number of jobs in 2022 was over 80,000 jobs. They also predict the job outlook to be 6%, which is faster than average, over 10 years, spanning from 2022 to 2032. So as we talk about whether or not this environmental science degree is worth it, it's important to consider those hard facts that we have on hand. Now, as you make the decision on whether or not you want to pursue a degree in environmental science, you want to ask yourself three questions to decide whether or not it is worth it. The first question is, how much do you enjoy the work? Now, if you've never done the work, that might be a little bit difficult, but you can make some educated guesses based on your high school courses and what you tend to do in your free time. So for example, in your free time, if you're going outside and being curious about the natural world, well, that might be a good indicator that you would excel in environmental science. If you took an AP environmental science class or biology classes in high school that you really, really liked, that also might be a good indicator that you would excel in environmental science. The second question is, how much do you align with the mission? Are you thinking about the impacts of climate change every day? Are you thinking about your carbon footprint as you go about your day? How much do you align with the mission that you would be living if you pursued a career in environmental science? Is that something that could motivate you when the work gets really hard or when it might not seem worth it? The third and final question that you're going to want to ask yourself is, how much does salary matter to you? And are you willing to have a lower salary at first just because you enjoy the work. A lot of what I saw online is that people are generally dissatisfied with the salary that comes with being an environmental scientist, but we know from our Bureau of Labor Statistics that the average is $78,980 per year. So it's important to keep that fact in mind when we're talking about what the online community is saying. Now, unfortunately, because environmental science is still a small degree and a small field in general, as we saw from the Bureau of Labor Statistics, it is going to grow by 6% over the next 10 years. So we don't have any survey data on the actual satisfaction that environmental scientists get from their career or from their degree. For this video, I turned to Reddit and saw what people were saying there. There are a few threads on whether or not pursuing an environmental science degree is worth it. And honestly, there was not a consensus that I found. Got a lot of different reviews, people saying they were unhappy with the degree and others saying that they were really happy that they did it. I really think it depends on the person. I remember there was one user who said that they didn't get paid very well, but they were the type of person who really didn't mind because they liked a more chaotic life. So again, just take all of that with a grain of salt and do some reflection on who you are and what your values are. Again, ask yourself those three main questions to see whether or not it really would be worth it to you specifically. Now, as for my opinion, I do think my degree in environmental science was worth it based on my own experience and the job opportunities that I got from it. I think there were a few things that made my environmental science degree worth it and led to the current job that I have now. You'll want to make sure that during your undergraduate degree, you are saying yes to things. You are going to events with other peers in environmental science. You are reaching out to your professors and trying to do research with them. You are expanding your professional network so that when the time comes to start applying for jobs, your opportunities are there. The number one tip I would say to make your environmental science degree actually worth it would be to hone in on your specialization as early as possible. Now, what do I mean by specialization? Well, within the umbrella of environmental science, there are so many different paths you can take. There's biological sciences and conservation, there's land use and forest management, there's energy and building science, there's environmental economics, there's agricultural sciences, or you could even go into policy. There's so many different specializations that you could take after you graduate, and the earlier you come to that decision, the better you will be, because then you can start tailoring your internships to that specialization, you can tailor your classes to that specialization, and really start to become an expert in that field. Now, with that specialization, you'll also want to start thinking about which sector to work in once you graduate. Now, I don't think this is something you have to figure out like freshman year of college, but it's definitely something that you'll want to have narrowed down by senior year. So what do I mean by sector? I honestly didn't really know what call this, but it's essentially like, who will you be working for when you graduate? Whether that's the local, state, or federal government, a for-profit company, a nonprofit company, or NGO. Will you be working for a consulting firm? What sector will you be in once you graduate? The consensus that I found online and from my own network and experience is that the more specialized you are and the more of an expert you are in your specialization, whether that's through your courses, further education, or jobs and internships, the more you'll get paid. The earlier on you can determine what your specialization is going to be, what sector you're going to work in, the better you'll be when you go to apply for those jobs. Now, if you're a new grad or a senior in college and you are starting to look for jobs and apply for jobs, and you are worried about the pay because you want your environmental science degree to be worth it, I would highly, highly, highly recommend checking out my most recent video on pay transparency. I shared a resource that I used to help negotiate my own salary to be higher. It's essentially a database that real environmental employees have entered in their salaries from hundreds of jobs across the country. Go check it out if you're in that current stage in your career. I hope this gave you a few things to think about as you're starting to consider pursuing a degree in environmental science. I know it wasn't a hard and fast answer, but honestly, nothing good will be. It does depend. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel. I do really appreciate it. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.